Hello everyone. So I'm sitting on the floor right now because I have all these boxes of stuff that I bought from Amazon to just upgrade my videos. I haven't done like videos in a long time besides just like vlogs, and I know the type of content and videos I like to watch, so I decided to just go ahead and invest so that I can put out the type of videos, the quality of videos that I myself like to watch. And I thought it was the perfect time because I had a bag that I actually returned, and I was just going to exchange it and get another bag, but I'm like, no, I'll use that money to just invest in something that I really enjoy doing, something I really like. So this is going to be an unboxing so that I can go ahead and start using my stuff. So again, like I said, most of this stuff is from Amazon, if not all of it. So yeah, this is the first box, and let's see what it is. Here we have, what is this, microphone. So I bought this microphone here. I watched a bunch of videos to see like what stuff I should buy, and I'll link the creators whose videos I watched that I really got a lot of help from to just know what stuff to get, what stuff is good, what stuff is not. So I bought this microphone here, and this is a lavalier microphone. So I bought this so that we could get the sound together, honey, get the sound quality together. And then this is, what is this? These are some, wait, I don't want to lie, these are batteries. Yes, these are batteries. Extra batteries and a charger for one of the cameras that I bought. And I bought some lenses, I bought some cameras, like a camera for vlogging. What is this? Oh, this is a microphone that I bought for my phone. This is a wireless microphone. I bought this for like when I'm recording on my phone, and right now I'm recording with the face front camera, but I bought like this little rig to put on the tripod so I can record with the back camera. But yeah, microphone for when I'm recording, like if I'm recording on the go from my phone. Y'all, I don't know what is in all this stuff. I know Amazon was sick of me. What's this? Memory cards. And y'all know I'm a mommy. I have two kids. I have a baby, and then I have Gigi that is 8 turning 9. So if y'all hear some stuff in the background, I'm doing laundry, kids are playing, I'm getting ready to cook dinner. Please ignore it if y'all hear some stuff in the background. So I got these two memory cards. These are the 128 gigabyte memory cards, so I got those. What is this? What is this? I'm asking y'all like y'all know. Okay. Man, this box was in with the other ones. This is a Telfar bag from a drop a couple months ago that was just kind of in there with the packages. Another one. Okay, then I got this light. This light is for my Sony camera. And then what is this? This is like a little, what is this? Swiss cold shoe ball head, something for camera. I know all this stuff goes for, oh, this is my little rig for recording on my phone. I'm using it for my phone, but if you have a camera that doesn't have a flip out screen, you can actually use this. And look, see it back there? it's like you hook it up and you're able to like see yourself. It's like a reflective, like a mirror little thing, so you're able to see yourself when you're recording with the face front. So I need to go ahead and put that on my phone now, but this video will just be this quality, and then we'll get into the goodness. We'll get to the good quality, y'all. And what is this? USB-C to mini B cable. I needed this. I think it was to like connect from my camera to my computer, something. All this stuff got a rhyme or reason, y'all. I just was doing research, and as I was doing research, I was ordering this stuff. What is this? Ouch. I'm using scissors because I don't know where a box cutter is. What is this? Oh, this is a monitor. This is a monitor. No, wait, I'm lying. This is a, like a little, you know when you use a little table for your laptop? So that's what this is. This is a little laptop table. That way I can have my laptop set up when I'm recording and I'll be able to see myself. So that's what that is. This was the camera that I bought 2 years ago when I told myself, oh, I'm gonna start back doing videos. So I bought this camera. It's the Canon PowerShot G7X, the Mark II. So I have this camera, which I've never even used. Let me see y'all. I have this camera, never used it. So I'm gonna, everything's still all tied up in there. Look. I'll give this a go and see what I think. I'm not sure how this quality is now, since this camera model, at the time it was the new model of this. Now it's a older model. So okay. Oh, this is one of my new cameras. Oh no, this is a lens. And here's a lens. This is the Canon 35mm, the f-stop 1.8, the macro lens, and it's RF because the camera that I got is from the new Canon, like the RF series. So I got this lens, and then I got this, which is a USB-C. It's an external hard drive. This one is 4 terabytes. The camera that I got is a 6K, like it shoots in 6K, then it compresses it to 4K. So I didn't want them files that'll be mad big. I didn't want those to just be like slowing down my computer or taking up a bunch of storage in my computer. So that's why I got an external hard drive. But I do want to be able to like film in like, you know, 4K and just great quality. Then we have this. What is this? This is another USB cord. This is a, where's my scissors? I think this is an adapter because one of the lenses that I got, and then I do have some lenses from back in the day, back when I did videos before with my old Canon camera. So I have some lenses that are they're not the RF, so I needed an adapter so that I can use other lenses that aren't RF. I can still be able to use those with I can still be able to use those with this new camera. Oh gosh. So yeah, this is an adapter. It's going to allow me to use E-mount lenses with my RF camera. So that's what this is. And I know y'all probably like, girl, what are you talking about? This stuff, if you are into like photography or film, videography, then this stuff, it is different. Each camera, like whether you have Canon, Nikon, Sony, they have like a different mounting system for the lenses, and you can buy lenses that aren't Canon lenses. Like for example, a Sigma lens, you can buy a Sigma lens and use it with your Canon camera. But if it's a different mounting system, you have to have an adapter that connects your camera to that lens, if that makes sense. And then, whoo, child, I was just on Amazon going crazy. Then this is a little phone, it's a mount for a phone or a camera, and this is like, it has a suction device, so it lets it like suction, you see it here, lets it suction to like a mirror or to somewhere else if you're out and don't have a tripod, or just to kind of get some cool angles. And before, when I was doing videos and stuff before, back in the day, I really was into photography, videography. So a lot of these things are just to really be able to get back into a hobby that I really loved and have like the equipment to do so. These were just some lens wipes for like camera, phone, shoot, if you wear glasses, lens wipes. What is this? I'm literally everything. I'm like, wait, what is this? What? Oh, then I got this, just a journal. I have like a journaling app on my iPad, but sometimes I just be needing to feel pen to paper, like real pen to paper. So I just got a journal so that I can, you know, journal things. My therapist, she be giving me homework assignments, so sometimes I'll do them in my phone, but some stuff I prefer to just write it on in there, child. And okay, where my camera's at? Because I'm opening up all these boxes and I'm not seeing my cameras yet. Please be in here, because I don't want to have no problems with Amazon, because a lot of this stuff was delivered like over a week ago, and I've just been waiting to have time to open it up, so I don't want no problems with them. Okay, this is a lens, and this is a Sigma lens for my Canon, my camera. Hopefully we'll get to the camera in one of these boxes, y'all. But this is the Sigma lens, and this was one that dang, y'all couldn't put it in no packaging. I mean, lenses ain't cheap, y'all. So to just put it in some a generic box in some plastic wrap, or what you call that. But yeah, this lens, this is a beast of a lens. If you shoot like, if you shoot videos and you want just a nice blurry background, this is a great lens to have. What, Amazon? I didn't order the used one. That's why it came like this, because this right here says used, but when I ordered it from Amazon, it said it was new. It didn't say it was a used lens, so I don't know. But this is the 30 millimeter. It has a f-stop of 1.4, so it's going to give you like a real nice blurry background when you have space between the object that you're shooting, and then the background is going to blur it out real nice. So this is great for like a nice sharp crisp video. It really don't look used, but I'ma still reach out to Amazon and be like, what's up? Like, what? What happened? I ordered a new lens. Why y'all send me one that say it was used? Like, let us just know before y'all do that. Give me a discount or something. I mean, dang, pay a regular price and then something come used. But I'ma hit them up. Amazon, they always have real great service, like customer service, if you reach out to them. So I'm just going to reach out to them and ask them about that, because I didn't, you know, usually with used stuff, you'll have to like click to see used item that was used on Amazon. It's not like it's default and it's like, hey, yo, this used. So I'm not really sure what's good with that, but I'll reach out to them. Then I have a wireless remote for my Canon. Hopefully we'll get to it. I have some stuff over here on this side. Hope y'all doing well. Hope everybody's having a good day. I know I haven't posted, like I didn't post in like a week when I said I would be posting twice a week, but transparency time, mental health. I needed just a mental health break. I had some things that have been like changing, and I have like high functioning anxiety, and change is not like, I don't really deal with change too well. So initially when something changes, I'd be like, what the hell, like what's going on? I don't like this. And it takes time for me to like just think through it and get acclimated to change. I just needed some time to just get myself together. And so sometimes I will try my best to just adhere to that schedule of posting twice a week, which right now is on like Sunday and Wednesday. But if you don't see a video from me, just know I'm just taking care of me. And I hope that you guys will take care of yourselves as well. Like, prioritize yourself, prioritize your mental health, and just take breaks when you need it. So this is a tripod, which I need to be using now because I got a little snack table with a box, and that's what we got rigged. So yeah, this is a tripod. It says, let me see if it worked with a phone too. Yeah, it says that it has like a mount for a phone or like your camera. So yeah, that's gonna come in handy. That's what I need. This is heavy. I'm thinking this should be my camera. Let's see y'all, this is a heavy one. I'm hoping it's my camera, hopefully both of them, because these other boxes are not looking like they would have a camera in it. But let's see, where's my scissors? I think I lost my scissors. Okay, no, that's something else. That's storage. I'm out of breath because I was really starting to panic, like where the hell these expensive ass cameras at. So this one I had already actually opened the box when it came. This is the Sony what is it, the ZV-1F camera. It does have like a flip out little screen, and this I got to use for vlogging. And there's another version of this camera where the lenses are like removable, and then you can purchase like different lenses to like capture different photos or to shoot different types of videos. I decided to get this version to just use for vlogging. I didn't need the removable lens option because I'm like a Canon girl when it comes to photography, when it comes to like film. I love Canon. That's what I'm used to. And I can tell by this is my other camera. This is the baby we've been waiting for. You know, this is what we've been waiting for. This is my baby. And yes, so here it is. This is the camera that I decided on. And yes, so I got this camera, which is the EOS R50 from Canon. And the R series just really attracted me because they are full frame cameras. So you're going to get kind of like a wider view of whatever you're shooting. And I get excited when I talk about film, when I talk about photography, because I don't know if y'all really know, like one of the things that I really grew a passion for was film, just from exploring YouTube back in the day. I know y'all be saying I'm an OG. Thank you. That's an amazing compliment to me, because there's a lot of us OG YouTubers that started 10 plus years ago, and especially us Black girls. So I just thank y'all for that. I love all the OGs. I love that people are still doing videos and that people are coming back. So yes, I love photography. Before I started doing videos on YouTube, that's kind of why when I would do like pictures on my blog or do like outfit pictures and stuff on my hair, outfit pictures and stuff on like Instagram and social media, like I really would like put a lot into my pictures because I always love photography. And through discovering YouTube back in the day, it grew a passion of film and videography for me. So that's why I'm just so excited about just getting back into a hobby. I feel like, y'all, it's, I don't know, maybe it's just me, I feel like it's hard to find like hobbies when you're like older. Like I'm 35 now and I'm just really like trying to rediscover what I really like. We kind of get so caught up in work and in whatever roles we have, be it wife, mother, daughter, caretaker. Like we get so caught up in those things that I feel like we forget about doing things for enjoyment, i.e. hobbies. And I'm like, I really loved photography and film. So I just wanted to invest in that hobby, in that passion of mine. So yes, here's the camera here. And then I do have the lenses. So I think I bought 3 lenses. It did come, I bought the kit, and the kit comes with the body of the camera. And then it also comes with a lens, like the kit lens. I know sometimes people know what they're going to be shooting, so they kind of opt for just buying the body of the camera. And of course you can always do that, but if you don't have other lenses, like this one does come with a kit lens. And let me see what the kit lens is. The kit lens is an 18 to 45 millimeter. This one is like a 4.5 to 6.3 for the like f-stop, and that's just going to be how you blur your background. So this kit lens ain't really finna give you no blurry background. It's not finna really do that. It'll blur it a little bit so that your subject is kind of, you know, standing out from whatever you're shooting. But yeah, it's, I just got the kit lens because I don't have a kit lens in this range, so I just decided to go ahead and just get the kit lens, get the one that came with the body and the kit. But y'all saw, I showed y'all 2 other lenses. I showed y'all what, the 30 millimeter, the 35, and then this kit lens. I have 3 lenses from my other Canon camera, which which one was that? I think it's the Canon 70, because I had the 5D Mark II, but I sold that back years ago when I really stopped doing videos and photography and stuff. So I think it's the 70. I think that's the one that I still have somewhere up in my attic, where stuff goes to just kind of just not ever be used again. But I'm glad I'm going to like reach back and say, hey, like, let me get back into this hobby and use my stuff again. And then it also came with like the battery and the charger. So that's that. I'm really excited about this camera. I'm excited to get back into, you know, get back into photography. And yeah, so let me just put all this away. And I showed y'all the Sony, I showed y'all the 2 lenses. What else we got? What else we got, y'all? Oh, to go with the Sony. And now I'm kind of thinking, I don't know if I really needed that, but I don't know, we'll see. What is this? I think this is some kind of rig, some kind of little mount something. Okay, so we got that. Now this, I don't know if it was a need or if I was just kind of just all up on Amazon just bullshit. But I bought this to go with the Sony camera. It is a vlogger kit. It's a like a little tripod specifically for the Sony camera that allows you to like you know, hold it kind of like a gimbal. I bought this gimbal, but y'all, maybe there's a learning curve. I gotta read the instructions more because I can't figure out how to work that thing. It just was like, had my phone just spinning. So hopefully this one is a little bit better. But it's specifically for the Sony camera, and it says wirelessly control your camera zoom, captures, and record functions. So that's what that is. We'll see how that goes. And then I have this camera, which I really think that I'm going to send back because I bought this one first before I was really like doing getting into the research and seeing like what was out there. I bought this camera, let me open it, and I think I'm going to send it back because it doesn't have a flip out. Is this one, is the Canon Rebel T7, so it doesn't have like a flip out screen or anything like that on this camera, and that's fine. And then also like kind of the Rebel series is a little bit, I think, is more beginner friendly, so it's geared more towards beginners. And you know, I really just want something you know, kind of more advanced, and I do want the full frame. It doesn't have the flip out screen, so I wouldn't be able to see myself when I was shooting. But yeah, the body of this actually feels like really nice though. It feels like substantial. It doesn't feel cheap or flimsy or anything. So I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to keep this or not. I don't need both of them. And yeah, so this one might go back. This also has the kit lens, and this is the 18-55mm kit lens. So I don't know. It might be nice to have like a little Canon for when I'm like somewhere where I don't want to take like my new camera, the R50. It might be nice to like have something else. So I'm going to consider it. I'm going to like weigh out my options and see what I'm going to do. But that's this one. And I'm going to shoot like some video with it and see, like kind of compare it. I know that it's probably not going to be very comparable just because of the differences in like the camera and like its functionality in the internal stuff of the camera. I know it's probably going to be like different, but still good. Like this is still a good camera. The Rebel series, like those are still great cameras, especially if you're a beginner and you're just kind of getting into DSLR cameras. But then here's the lens. So I don't know, I'm gonna think about it. I'm gonna see what I'm gonna do, if I'm going to keep this or if I'll return this one, because I'm definitely holding on to my Sony, the R50 Canon. And also I'm going to keep like my other this little Canon point and shoot. This one, is that upside down? Yeah, this one. Because I think these are nice and easier to kind of carry around because they're smaller, but quality wise like they're still pretty good, especially for video. So I think I'm going to like just maybe get rid of this because I feel like that'd be kind of like my like wanting to hold on to things-ness kicking in when I'm like having too much, when I have too much and I just don't want to like let go of something. And I don't want to do that because we're working on that and we're unpacking that. That's why we have therapy once a week. So I don't want to kind of get into doing that. Y'all feel me? I'm sure y'all get what I'm saying. But yeah, so, oh, and then this big box that's sitting here right next to me is actually a lighting system. So I'm just going to kind of put up a picture of the lights where y'all can see it, because it's going to be no way for me to hold up these 10 lights in this video. So yeah, that wasn't anything tech wise. That's just sports bras. Let's see what this is. Some workout leggings. But I guess I'll show y'all, because these are these it's a workout shirt, it's a workout jacket, but this is I scraped my skin off. Ouch. Oh wow, this thing stinks. Maybe it's this part. It has this. It's like a sauna jacket. So, yeah. It's a little zip-up jacket. Because I used to be in a gym like Missy Elliott with the, you know, the Gold's Gym. Like the workout. Like the big thing that looked like a big trash bag. But it's just, I will only wear the top. I wouldn't wear the bottom. But I used to be in there looking crazy. So, I'm glad that they made this, which is more discreet. So it gives you like the features of like the sauna, like the stuff to help you sweat, more, but it doesn't look like it. So I got that. What else we got? I feel like we've seen, oh, there go. I found my scissors. And oh, my baby's getting fussy. It's her nap time. So I'm about to just hurry up and get through this, and then I'm going to get my baby. Oh, what's this? This is some stuff I ordered from Ulta. Yeah, that's Ulta. Oh, then this a Big Daddy. This a Big Daddy tripod. This the big boy tripod. Yeah, so this one is for like my camera, for my Canon, big boy. Then that first tripod I showed y'all, that was more so for my phone. What is this? Like, y'all, when I tell y'all I really finna give y'all that quality, when I tell y'all, because look, I done got me a big boy microphone. Like the podcast bros, like the dudes that be on the podcast just talking all day. Yeah, I done got me one of those. So it got the little rig on it. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Do not play with her. So yes, I really was on Amazon, like just really not playing. So what is this? Oh, this is like a little rig thing. For the Sony camera. What's this? Oh, this is another little surge protector thing. And then what's this? This is a battery, a charger, and extra batteries for one of the cameras. I got it for both cameras, for the Sony and Canon. I got like the extra charger and extra batteries, just so that when I'm shooting, when I get the chance to like shoot videos, I can just go ahead and just let the creativity flow, get my videos done without having to worry. Because that used to happen to me a lot back in the day when I did videos before. Like I would be recording, I'll be in my zone, I'll be like, yeah, like I'm about to record mad videos, and then camera would die, then I'm sitting there, makeup getting old, hair getting old, and I'm sitting there having to wait for the camera to charge. So just making sure that I have everything that I need, so that when I get inspired, or when I have, you know, free time, when I'm not working, or the kids are with the grandparents are gone, I can take care of that. Lights. Like, this box is huge. Like, and it's, I think it's two LED lights. Oh, these No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Them is heavy. Oh my gosh. No, I can't open those, y'all. I can't open them down here. But yeah, those are light. What is this? Something else. What is this? Oh yeah, this is a thing I saw in a video that I watched, and when I tell you, she has amazing videos about like photography, videography, lighting, microphones. Please check out her videos. I'm gonna link her channel down below. But she talked about this where you can plug it into your camera while you're shooting, and it's like some type of battery little thingamajig, so you get to still it's like charging your, I don't know, it's something. You're shooting videos, a lot of times the battery will die so quickly on your camera, especially depending on what like what format you're shooting in. So yeah, I got that. Wait, what is this? Oh, this is a cold shoe adapter for my Sony camera. Got that. And wait, it was something else. I also got a table, like wait, and then I got this. This is just an LED mirror, so I can see myself when I'm shooting. Please leave me some comments down below letting me know what type of videos you guys are interested in. Yes, my ideas are just kind of fashion videos. I'm trying to rediscover my style as a 35-year-old. Like, I'm trying to rediscover my style as somebody that has been working remotely for over 3 years now. And, you know, you get so accustomed. First, I was like still getting dressed and stuff to get on my computer and work. I was still getting dressed every day as if I were going to the office. Then it got to the point where I would put on the top, like I'll dress my upper body and then have like pajama bottoms on. Then it got to the point where I was just kind of just working in pajamas, and now I'm trying to get back to like putting myself together, it not mattering where I'm going. Like, I just want to, like, you know, you look good, you feel good. I'm trying to like rebuild my confidence. So, you know, just kind of on this journey of rediscovering my style as someone that's 35, because I ain't trying to look young, but I'm not trying to look too mature either. I'm trying to find like the right fit and the right balance of how I want to present myself. And that can change from day to day, from week to week, from month to month, and that's okay too. But just trying to, you know, just find myself. So let me know if you guys are interested in seeing that, because I was just thinking about doing a series on that particular thing, like finding your style as someone that, I guess 35 might be middle age, as like a middle-aged woman. I don't know, that sounds weird, as somebody that's 35, or even being older, you know, how you want to dress. You want to be youthful but not too young, you know. You want to be sexy, you know, a little, but not too sexy. You don't want to be too, like, you know, too corporate, too mature, too business casual, especially when you like chilling. So just kind of trying to find that. You know, makeup, getting back to tutorials. I feel like, you know, right now what's in is a lot more of like lifestyle, which I love. I watch a lot of lifestyle videos and content, but I kind of want to go back to when we used to teach each other stuff, when we used to learn stuff. Like, I learned how to do makeup on YouTube, I learned how to do my hair on YouTube, I learned how to do everything almost on YouTube. So I want to get back to that sense of where you can come and you can see something that you can learn from and enjoy, you know, that's entertaining, but you're learning something too. That's kind of the vibe that I want to have on my channel. So let me know if you're vibing with that. Also, like cooking videos, still like the vlog, still sharing like my fertility journey. So if y'all have any questions about my fertility journey, please let me know. I'll also be like posting like my fertility journey, posting like my pregnancy, because I was just recording on my phone during that time. Still doing the mental health check-in, so tap in down below. Like the past, I want to say week or two, like mentally it was a lot for me. Like again, like I said, change, like I'm not big on change, especially initially when I learn of something new or something that's changing from how it was before. Like I initially get nervous, I initially start to panic, and then it takes me some time. Once I start to think about it and work through like the initial shock, then I get to the point where I'm like, okay, you know, I got this. No matter what, I can roll with the punches. So, you know, it's just been a lot. So like mentally, I'm much better today and this week than I was last week, which is okay. Like going through the motions, the self-work, when you're working on yourself, it's a lot. It's work, and it's not always going to be easy. So I'm kind of like in that space where I'm accepting of that. It's not going to be easy all the time. Growth is not always comfortable. Shit, if it was, we would all be doing it and flourishing, and it would be no problem. But it is uncomfortable at times, and when you get to those uncomfortable patches, uncomfortable seasons, just learning to like push through and work through. Because every time I've like come into a new season or I've hit like a bump in my journey, I've always overcome it and I've always come out better. So just know that if that's what's going on for you, I pray that you get through whatever it is that you're going through. If you want to share, feel free to share down below in the comments. If you would rather like share one-on-one privately, you can email me, you can hit me up on IG. My IG is iam.growingandglowing. Some of them lines, I'll put it down below. I'll put my IG down below in the comments. So if you just want to like hit me up, like please feel free to. And yes, so that's what I have going on. Now you'll probably see like some vlogs that I recorded last week, a weekly vlog. You'll see that, and then of course my fertility journey and pregnancy videos. Those will be like on the old quality, but videos, new videos going forward will be using all this stuff that I done bought, because I'm finna get my money's worth. About to get my money's worth, and I'm really going to put in the work and put forth the effort. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the new quality. Again, let me know down below what type of videos y'all want to see, what you're interested in. If you have like questions, like just holler at me, just let me know. And I do work Monday through Friday, so sometimes if you see me like responding to some comments and then, you know, there's you commented and I haven't responded, please know I'm gonna get through all of them. I do them at night when my kids are in the bed and I'm in the bed. I just go through and just like respond to as many as comments as I can before I go to sleep, because my mama has to get up and work. So yeah, just know that I will get back to you. And yes, I hope that everybody is giving yourself grace. Like, hasn't been the easiest of times, so I hope you guys just take time to prioritize yourself, even if it's only 15 minutes, 20 minutes a day, or every couple days when you can. Just prioritize some time to yourself and give yourself grace. And I will make sure to practice and remind myself to do the same. So thank you for all of the support. What the hell? I was gonna get off here and not thank y'all for all the love that y'all showed. Like when I tell you, I was like reading them comments and grinning from ear to ear, or bawling out crying, because you guys really show so much love, such a warm welcome. And I'm so grateful for all the support. Like when I tell y'all, I was like on cloud nine. Like I was feeling so good just reading the comments, responding to the comments. So thank y'all for just showing me the support And I was like nervous about posting those videos that I posted. When was it? I think it's been 2 weeks now. I was so nervous about coming back, ending my little hiatus from social media, because I haven't posted nothing on social media since last year. It's been about 8-9 months. So it just felt so good. It probably was longer than that. I don't know. Probably over a year. It felt so good to come back to such a warm welcome and to be received so well, for y'all to be like rocking with me and just vibing with me. Like, the vibe has been vibing, and I feel so good to know that, you know, I'm so much greater than my fears, and that's why I'm coming to you guys with this message, that you're so much greater than your fears also. Because when I tell you, I like went back and forth for years about coming back to YouTube just out of like my worst fears, fear of being seen trying, doing something, and to be able to literally be overcoming my fear and have a sense of community, have people that I know got my back, people, some people that I never even met before, some people that I have had the pleasure of meeting just on this journey. So I just thank y'all so much for just showing up and just supporting, and it never goes unnoticed with me. Like, I'm so appreciative and I'm so thankful. So thank you. And now I could go, because I was really finna get off this and not thank y'all, and I don't know what I was thinking, but thank you, and I hope to see you in the comments so that we can chat it up, we can talk about everything that we talked about in this video, and just see how y'all are doing. And until my next video, I'll holla at y'all.